In OBS Studio, you can create, live stream, or record any type of image slideshow you can dream of. It's really cool, underutilized feature. Check it out. Under the sources section, hit the plus button right here. You hit this button and then you're going to select image slideshow. Name yours something that makes sense to you. I'm going to use the default for this tutorial. It'll pull open this properties window for your image slideshow. Let's go over the options because there are multiple ways for the slideshow to be facilitated here under slide mode, where you can have it automatically go through your slideshow by just going through the slides at a specific timing. I'll teach you how to do that. And there's also a manual mode where you can create hotkeys to go through your slideshow, similar to any custom presentation like in PowerPoint or Google Slides. I'm going to show you both methods today. So your visibility behavior, don't be confused by this. It will always play in the background, even when you're not on this scene, if you leave it on the default. So what that means is as soon as you boot up OBS, this slideshow is just going to be playing and playing and playing, even if you're not even showing the scene in OBS, if you leave it on default. If you want, you can have this scene where your slideshow is located do other things. Like say, for example, you switch to a different scene. You can select this option where it stops when you're not actually looking at the slideshow, and then it restarts when you come back to the slideshow. Or whenever you leave the slideshow, it can pause when you're not looking at it, and then it unpauses when you come back to it. You can choose which behavior you would appreciate and you would like based on your needs. First, we're going to start with automatic as our slideshow. It's just going to play on its own once we load images in here. The transition we'll use is fade. It is the kind of best generic way to go between slides that's not going to surprise viewers or turn them off. Now your time between slides, milliseconds right here, let me break this down for you. It's in milliseconds. It should just be in seconds in my opinion, but anyway, 8,000 milliseconds is 8 seconds. So if we wanted to speed up from the default, I can drop it down to 4 milliseconds and it would only show the content there for 4 seconds if you type in 4,000, okay? The transition speed between slides is in milliseconds as well. So 700 milliseconds, the default, is actually 1/7 of a second. So if you wanted to take a half a second to go between slides, you type in something like 500. You can choose to loop the slideshow over and over and over again or not by checking this button. You can hide the entire thing when it's done if you want by checking this button. And you can mix it up, kind of do shuffle play by clicking the randomize playback button. It is up to you. Today I'm gonna loop it and randomize it just to show you those features in this tutorial. Great. The bounding size and aspect ratio, I recommend using automatic for most users, but you can decide to automatically change the aspect ratio of your slides to widescreen 16:9, or any other resolution you want if you want to resize the images. I recommend not doing that, and I recommend just choosing automatic for most cases. Now, it's time to load your images into the slideshow by hitting the plus button right here. You can select multiple images when you do this by hitting plus and adding files. Now, you can add a directory if you want. Basically, you can add an entire folder of images if you wanted to. We're going to manually add files today as the alternative. I'm going to choose some thumbnails from my podcast, the Digital Drop Podcast for content creators. I'm going to choose these 4 images. Now, the way that I chose multiple in a row is I click the first one, I hold down shift, click another one, click another one, click another one, and then it keeps all 4 of those in this list of images we are loading into OBS. Then hit open. Now all of those images are here, and now they're doing the actions that we told it to do. As you can see, it's switching between the slides every 4,000 milliseconds. It's doing it with a half a second transition. It's looping them, and it's randomly playing them back, just like we told it to do, okay? And if you're watching these slides and they're popping up too fast, slow down, for example, the time that they're on the screen by increasing time between slides. Now it's gonna be 10 seconds in between each of the slides because I bumped that up to 10,000 milliseconds. You guys get it, right? Awesome. Let's say you do not want it to automatically move between the slides and you want to manually control them. Go up to slide mode and select, instead of automatic, select manual, which requires you to use hotkeys in order to trigger the slides to move between one slide to the other. So we'll go ahead and hit OK. As you can see, the slides are not transitioning on their own. Hit OK. And now in the bottom right-hand corner under Settings, we need to go assign our hotkeys that you're going to use to move between your slides. Click Settings. It's going to pull up this menu. Hotkeys are kind of buried over here in this menu. Right here, this is your hotkeys menu. Let's go into hotkeys and let's just make one hotkey for this tutorial, and you can make all the rest on your own. We'll make one hotkey as an example, and you can do the rest on your own as you see fit. Scroll down the hotkeys list to the very bottom, and as you can see, here are the controls for image slideshow right here. So your different options here include play, pause, restart, stop, and then there's next slide and previous slide. I recommend doing next slide and previous slide. So I'm going to do Q for next slide and W for previous slide, just as an example today. Once you enter your hotkeys here, hit apply or they won't work, and then hit OK. And then now that I'm in my slide presentation, I can do Q to move to the next slide, Q. Oh, I accidentally went too far forward, W to go back, etc. You guys get it. And you can assign your hotkeys as needed. And if you're looking to do your own presentations, your own conference, your own whatever, I'm here to help you with the technical elements, help you with your digital strategy. I am a digital executive that has now gone independent to help clients with their technology, with their YouTube channel, with their live streams. You can book me by going to awalldigital.com, link in the description below. Select your day, select your time, and literally just enter some basic information, what you want me to help you with here in this form, and then pay, and boom, I'm on a one-on-one video call with you, helping you with all of your technology and online broadcasting needs in an instant.